today when I walked into the studio here at CAM, the sign says, "Who are you and what is your story?" And that's what we're going to find out today. We are going to introduce our audience to Zachariah Sharif, who is running for Erie School Board. So, Zachariah, let's start with a synopsis of your life story, your education, your family, your career, and talk about your love of Erie.
Okay, first of all, I'd like to say thank you, Liz, for taking this time. So my name is Zachariah Sharif. I was originally born in Somalia. I came here in 96, left my country when I was 3 years old due to war, and then after that was in Kenya for refugee camp for 5 years. I arrived here in 96, where it all started in Erie, city of Erie, where my parents, with eight kids, seven boys and one girl. And they fell in love with Erie because it was a nice city to raise their children. I'm a prodigy of the Erie City Schools. Started from Glover Cleveland all the way, graduated from East High School in 2006. Then I went on to graduate from Penn State, went to main campus my first year, and then came back to Penn State Erie, graduated with business management and marketing. Did a lot of work in manager position in hospitality, but currently I'm employed with the Erie County Department of Health for almost the last 2 years.
Okay, so what first motivated you to run for Erie School Board?
So one thing I should have mentioned also is I'm married to my beautiful wife, Sarah Sharif. We currently have four kids and one on the way. So one of the things we currently have three children who are attending Lincoln Elementary School. So for me, I wanted to be not just a parent, but I wanted to advocate not just for my children, but for all the children, all the students in the city.
And I know from our previous conversation that education was really important for your entire family, for your siblings and everything. Everybody ended up being successful because of a good education that they got in Erie.
Absolutely. So education, it was very critical for me, especially my parents always told us, like, education will open many doors, keys to many doors. So especially, graduating, my older brother also going to Penn State, me being the first graduate, and then my brother who also graduated from Gannon. Just not just the education, but the people that you meet, the navigation, you meet so many people that through education, through a degree that you normally wouldn't be able to meet.
And that kind of brings us to our first question about what you would bring to the Erie School Board. I know you have some specific ideas on how to help Erie school children. First, let's hear about your ideas for what's working and what could be improved in the classroom.
So we know that our teachers, our staffs, administrators, and students faced a lot in the last almost 2 years with the pandemic. A lot has been exposed with the education, the lack of just resources that our public schools have. So one of the things is definitely needing somebody to advocate, making sure the money is going towards supporting the students as holistic. We gotta figure out like what we're spending money on. And I know budget's always been an issue, but one of the things that I would truly bring is being from a business background and just holding myself accountable and everyone accountable that we're doing the right thing for the children.
Okay, and you also told me you're familiar with after school programs. So talk about your ideas on after school help. Which settings work best for kids and why?
So I just want to touch on a little bit. I told you when I came in, I barely spoke any English. So I really didn't feel comfortable staying after school. So one of the places that I went to was either a multicultural center. I went to the JFK or Quality of Life, where you can easily adapt to, like, you already see kids are coming there and doing homework, being assistant, you feel comfortable. So I think, especially now, just talking to some teachers and even some administrators from the school district, they really didn't have that much success with after school programs and low turnout. So I think some of the money should be allocated targeting exactly the communities that where these children actually go, funding some of the budget towards that, and I think this would hugely impact the kids.
And we didn't talk about this question beforehand, but at those community centers, you found you were probably among your peers. I mean, maybe you found somebody else who had come from Somalia, somebody else who was not an English language speaker at the beginning. Is that part of the atmosphere you find at a community center? And do you also make friends there?
Absolutely, not just the Somali. We have people from different parts, the Middle East, you have Asians. So it's just the comfortable level, and you're not the only one who's going through the same rope. So kids, I've just seen, even till today, and some of the volunteers that are doing in certain communities, kids more tend to come where they feel more comfortable. And I think this will be a great, great way to channel that.
Okay. You already started talking about this, your business background. So I know you've thought about the school director's role at budget time. So let's talk about that. You have talked about the balance that's needed. You need the funding. You're also a homeowner. The property taxes. So talk about that and what expertise and questions you would bring to the budgeting process.
So even like meeting with the superintendent, they talk about decline in our students or not having funding. But some of the things that they're talking about is adding more administrators, using some of the ARP money. And I agree with a lot of the ideas, and one of them was we talked about was the after school programs and some of the money in the next 3 years being spent. And one of my ideas to the superintendent was it would directly impact having these things in the community. But as far as adding more administrators, in the long haul, it's not gonna be sustainable for the school district because those are incurring costs. And I'm sure later on we'll probably touch on some of the other sensitive topics, adding more to the budget.
Can you elaborate on the vision you have about how good public schools can boost the quality of life in our city? They're tied together. You can't have one working on let's improve the city without thinking about education and what keeps families in the city, families with children, senior citizens who want to make sure that the next generation is educated and contributing. So talk about that a little bit.
Absolutely. Thank you for mentioning that, because we talk about just in the city and sometimes not just the school district but other government entities need to work together. We're talking about just in the sense of the decline of population. We're talking about and it ties to directly to education, because sometimes you have students who graduate who necessarily might not even stay here, so providing the right curriculums, the connection. So for I'm very proud that we now have a community college building a curriculum that directly gonna impact students. We can build, I know the school district is doing something right now with research how they can target directly what interests the students. And this would be a great segment. We have the community college. We also have these top colleges in our area. And not just kids graduating from school, but providing that they can get a nice job and stay here and contribute to the economy. We due to closing schools, it has been not enough. We don't have enough, the population is declining, but we need to engage the youth and be able to keep them. So I think not just the school district, but all government entities should work, especially the city, the county need to work to figure out what's best for the kids and to keep children here. Because I have friends who I graduated with, they decided not to stay in here. They wanted to go to a bigger city because more opportunities, but we have to create that opportunity here in the city. And I believe our city is very beautiful. We have a lot of things that people don't take advantage of. And that's one of the things I want to advocate for. We need to bring our graduation rate higher. We need to focus on attendance, those kind of things.
I think you've also talked about the community college, making sure that high school students know that community college is an option, not letting them get out of school and then figure out a few years later, maybe I can go to the community college. So I think you talked to me about that.
Absolutely, because often, I know with a lot had to do with the pandemic and a lot of it was virtual learning, especially for the high school. I actually helped a couple students register for the community college because there was just that gap. They didn't know how to get the information, the resources, because necessarily doesn't mean they have to, after they graduate, they stop, but this is a great option. Get the maybe associate degree and they can after that go right into the workforce or down the road continue their education. Some of the credits might be transferable. I think this is huge. We have to work closely with our, and I think the school district is kind of, they're taking that step forward, and this is a really great opportunity to give our students.
We're coming up on the 5-minute mark here, so we have a lot to cover in 5 more minutes. So you want to talk about community schools, maybe diversity and inclusion, and state fair funding. So kind of three big issues. We don't have a lot of time to talk about them, but let the audience know that you are on top of those issues. I know that you are. So community schools, equity and inclusion, and state funding.
So let me talk about the diversity, equity, okay. Inclusion. And we know that, again, with the pandemic, a lot has been exposed. And when we know a lot of our inner city students are 35% minorities, black or brown colored, mm-hmm. and there's not enough representation, this matters. And research shows that we need somebody that looks like the children that they can relate to. And the school, they're doing something moving forward, but we need not just from teachers, but we need from the top to bottom. We need from the administrators to staffs. We need more representation, somebody advocating for everybody. So, and I think that's very important. And then you mentioned the community schools.
Yes.
And actually, I love the idea of community schools. Actually, just today, earlier, I read about it in an article by Raymond Pierce. It talks about how community schools can be a game changer for public education. But let's talk about why can it be a game changer. They're talking about, for community college, hiring the right people. I think this is huge, hiring the right people that can connect to parents and, you know, and resources. We talked about, you know, connecting them to the mental health. We're talking about the whole holistic of the kids' mental health, social workers, and after school programs, not just school programs. And sometimes people may not understand the school should function as almost like a health center, because we know that the answer is complicated, but we know students do better with higher quality education when the whole mind and the kids are coming to school fed. They have a place to stay and good environment, and those kids automatically, research shows that their score level and everything goes up. And I think the community college, and I'm glad that that's something in that 5-year plan, that the school strategy working towards that, and I think I'm continuing to support that.
Well, I know that you've done your homework. You've dived into the issues, and we can't solve the fair funding of public education here at the state level, but I know that you would be on top of that. And that's another heavy lift for school directors, is to advocate at the state level. So I wanna make sure that people know where your name is on the ballot, how they can help if they'd like to, and what else do you need from voters before the general election on November 6th?
So you can find my name. I have a Facebook page, Zachariah Sharif for School Board, and you go right link to that, and it will give you all the information about me. And I also, I'm a candidate with Erie County United, and we have canvassing, we have phone banking. Please go on my website, Zachariah Sharif for School Board, and find information. We definitely need volunteers, any assistant, or anybody who wants to donate. I'll appreciate that.
Okay, what can you do to get some first-time volunteers out there and young people to want to be part of this campaign?
So I'm glad you mentioned that, because, you know, I personally feel local elections matters, and we don't focus on that enough. How we often focus on the big elections, mm-hmm. but people that we elect here in the city or in the county are those people who are going to be advocating, that will be going to Harrisburg, that will be going to Washington. So picking the right people is definitely important, and I encourage, and I don't know the correct date, but it's coming on
coming,
us
coming
on October,
yeah.
to register early. So I encourage the younger ones, like I said, visit my webpage. You can shoot me an email or message.
Okay, and we have a minute here. We're counting down the last seconds. So say your name again, tell people your website and your Facebook page.
As I mentioned, my name, Ms. Liz Allen mentioned, my name is Zachariah Sharif. Page is Zachariah Sharif for School Board. And I just would like to take the time to thank Ms. Liz Allen for taking the time to do this interview. And I hope I can make a difference. Please support me on November 2nd. I'll be on the ballot, number 7 on the ballot. So I really appreciate it.
Okay. Thank you so much. This was a pleasure. And I hope everybody got to know a little bit about more in 15 minutes about who he is and what his story is.
Thank you once again.
Thanks.